good, guys? It is Reed, and welcome back to another video. Today we got a really cool tutorial, a move of mine I call the broken pass. Now, this is something that I came up with playing around one day, and it's one of those moves that will absolutely not fool the camera, but it works really well in person. It's super fooling, and it does need a bit of misdirection. It's one of those kind of moves. You'll also get some of my philosophies on the classic pass, not something I've talked about much. I think I touched on it a bit on in a live stream one time, but I don't use the classic pass much. I have some philosophies on it and some ways that I handle it that I'd be open to sharing. If you guys are interested, let me know. But you will see a little bit of those philosophies in this video with the broken pass, but it's pretty cool control. So I hope you guys enjoy it because I think it is a really fun control. One of those things that you almost can't believe it fools anyone, but it does. So as always, if you guys like these videos, don't forget to like, subscribe, all that good stuff. If you'd like to check out private lessons, take a look at the link below and let's get into a demonstration of the broken pass. All right, guys. So like I said, broken pass is not fooling anyone on camera, but hopefully you can, you know, set aside your camera lens bias and see how valuable of a move this can be in the real world. So we will have a card selected. Spectator can sign it, you know, show everyone, do all that good stuff. Take it, place it on top of the deck. And just make sure, this is really important. I really don't want you to forget this card, right? Okay, it's super important for this. So watch, we'll take it and I will very carefully leave it in the middle of the deck, right? That's not it. We'll leave it somewhere in the middle, but incredibly, if I just cast a shadow over these cards, one card actually jumps right back to the top, and it is the Six of Hearts. So that was a broken pass. So hopefully you guys can kind of see what's going on here, but it is a super deceptive move and one that's a lot of fun, and in a way allows you to practice your pass if that's something you're interested in the real world, you know, with real spectators and all that kind of stuff. So essentially this move, and the reason it's called the broken pass, is because you're breaking up the pass into a different moment. You're passing the cards on the offbeat, and then you're almost introducing the situation like nothing has changed, but you've already completed the pass. So it's almost like you've done the move, and instead of just moving on, you're going back to where you were before you did the move and trying to convince the spectators, or you are convincing the spectators that you've never left that moment, right? That's kind of the goal here. So really the mechanics are nothing crazy. Again, this isn't really a classic pass tutorial, so I'll just quickly go over the pass mechanics that I use. If you'd like a full tutorial on the classic pass, let me know. But it's more so on the psychology and the justifications behind this move to how to be able to pull it off. So quickly, let's touch on some of these mechanics. So the pinky's gonna be jammed way inside the break, not like a normal pinky break, it's gonna be up to that first knuckle, and then these two fingers are gonna pinch really hard over top, the ring and middle. Now you're gonna pull these around, okay? So these are getting pulled slightly back and down and around. As the ring finger pulls this packet that pivots, it's gonna pivot on the middle finger and be pulled by the ring finger. So it just pivots. And that's gonna be pulled out of the way and that's gonna be passed to the bottom. Okay, so you see the grip and then I pull back into the side as these fingers pull up and then that goes around. So that is generally the mechanics, okay? I'm not gonna talk too much about how to hide it, angles and that sort of thing, because this one doesn't need to be hidden, okay? You can do a very sloppy pass right in the open, sort of think Danny D'Ortiz style. I don't know if you guys have ever seen him do his pass, but he just, you know, comes like this. You know, he just literally pulls that packet out and dribbles it on top or whatever. He doesn't try to hide it or anything. And he gets away with it all the time because he's, you know, the psychology master. So, you know, use your, whatever pass is comfortable for you, but essentially you just need to be able to pull that top packet around to the bottom. And again, really important, as you pull back and out this way, this ring finger is gonna pivot on the middle finger and clear that packet out of the way, allowing the bottom packet to go underneath. That's really all the mechanics you need. We're gonna talk about how to achieve this control with the justifications and the movements and all that stuff. So there's a couple things that's important. So you have your card selected however you want. I think it is nice from a dribble because then you have your packet split. If you wanna do it from a spread, you can, and then you can just kinda, you know, either tab them, tell you when to stop and do it, or whatever you want. But I always liked it from a dribble. So you have the card selected. At this point, you have it signed, shown around, all that stuff. Now, this is important. You wanna have the hands like this. You wanna have the, you know, which is pretty normal. The hand with the top packet in a biddle grip held back here, And this is the normal grip you'd have for the pass, right? So nothing's gonna change. So if it's not a perfect middle grip, how you do your pass, maybe you always curl your finger on top when you're about to do your pass, have that, you know, this hand be in that same position so you can get into the pass as quickly as possible. Okay, so you have that hand ready in a pass position back here, basically a middle grip, this hand in kind of a regular, just holding the cards mechanics grip. So they're gonna return the card. And as you do that, you immediately, you just slowly kind of bring the hands together. Okay, bring the hands together, and as they come together, immediately the pinky goes in here and these shoot on top. Okay, so it's like this. You can see they just go straight into position. And as they go into position, then they do the pass. So it all happens in one fluid motion, and that's the goal here. Right, that's the goal. Come, pass. And you can kind of get this nice circular motion, right? As the hand comes forward. So essentially, the sort of justification, how you would think of this in the spectator's mind, is your hands are coming together to rest for a second, almost like they return the card, they come together, and then you're showing them the moment it goes into the middle. Or you can think of it, you know, from their perspective that you brought the cards together and then you realize, oh, I want to be really fair about this, so let me show them again. So there's kind of those two options. I don't really address this. You know, some people might think you come together, you do the pass, and you say, oh wait, let me show you this, you know, really, really fairly before I lose your card. So in their mind, it would be you brought your hands together, you were about to lose their card, and then you realized, oh, actually, let me show you this really fairly that your card goes in the middle. And I don't not like that. I think that's a very justified, decent idea where they place the card back and you say, okay, perfect. Actually, here, let me show you this really fairly go in the middle like that. You've already done the control. So that works. I personally just don't draw much attention to it. I come back and I kind of just bring like my hands come together for a second and then I say watch as it goes into the middle. And so that, you know, that was me not doing anything. But if I were to actually do the pass, my hands would come together and I'd say, okay, watch. And that would actually be the move versus my hands coming together and then coming out and not doing anything. Basically, you want to have that motion where your hands come together, and as this happens, these are gonna, like I said, go straight into position, and all that needs to happen is these top fingers need to grip the bottom packet. So they just move extremely slightly from there to there. So that all happens, boom, you see the hands re-grip, and then I pull, and this can be super sloppy, like it doesn't have to be anything hidden, anything special, because you just bring the hands far apart, right? You just kind of pull this top packet out of the way and let those fall into your bottom hand. Now, another thing that's super important is to ask a question as you do the move, right? As your hands come together. So they place the card back and you say, you won't forget your card now, will you? And one thing that's great is it justifies now this hand coming forward and you can point with it, and that also kind of helps with the method. So remember, grab that bottom packet and just lift it right out of the way. You don't even really need to pull the top out of the way as long as you just pull the bottom out from underneath. And that's a lot of the times what I just do. So you come together and now you just pull it out of the way as you point, and this packet will naturally fall into a mechanics grip, right? If you want to add a bit of extra speed, you can add a little bit of pull here, but you really, really do not need it. And that's what one of the things that makes this a really easy pass variation, because you don't need to keep everything hidden and together and nice and square. You know, you can just pull that bottom packet out. And now you have a great justification with the point. So they place a card back and you say, okay, you won't forget that card, will you? And they say no. And now, obviously the packets don't go like this. Like, no one's gonna think that. Obviously this is normal. They just put the card back here. So that little question, right? When you ask that question, they say no, and you'll say, you sure? You can even say, you sure? What was the card then? Just prove it to me that you haven't forgotten. You're just now adding a little bit of time misdirection. You really do not need much, a couple of seconds, but asking them, you know, you won't forget that card, will you? With the point, super great subtlety, you won't forget that card, will you? And they say no, and you say, okay, just prove it to me. What was the card? And they'll say, you know, whatever it was, two of hearts in this case, and you say, okay, perfect, watch. I'm gonna leave that very fairly in the middle of the deck, and the control has been achieved because the card was in the other packet, right? So that's the broken pass. It's really, really great, and it's all about the subtlety. So let's talk about those really quickly. Again, the time misdirection and the question are the big ones. So you have the card replaced, you come here, and you say, wait, what was your card again? You won't forget it, right? And they say yes, and now you're already way ahead of them, right? So it's just about getting that one moment to fly. So what I would recommend is you do the pass as you come forward, you pull this packet out, you come forward and point. You say, what was your card? You ask them a question so they get, you know, their attention somewhere else, and you bring your eyes up and you look them in the eye and they will follow. Okay, and that'll get all the attention away. You ask the question and then add a little bit of time misdirection here so that they, you know, they'll be, you know, sure that their card must have been there. You don't want to add too much to the point where they kind of forget that they put it back here and all those things, but just a little bit. And, you know, don't be afraid. Once, you know, they're certain that their card is here, don't be afraid to really milk this moment because you're so far ahead, right? Maybe you can even, you know, take your, you know, set this packet down completely hands off, and yet the card's controlled at the top. And coming forward will also kind of block it a little bit. You can see how I kind of come like this, and then I use, like in a normal pass, I use this finger to lever up, and now I get all this cover. And that'll just kind of help cover everything like that, and as I point. So they place the seven of spades here, and I say, wait, what was your card again? You won't forget it, right? And they'll say, no. You say, okay, watch. I'll lose your card right in the middle of the deck, and the control has been achieved. So quickly, another idea with this broken pass is doing it with multiple cards or mixing it with other controls. So of course, you could have the two cards placed on top at the same time and do the move, but I kind of like doing it, you know, at separate times. So what you would do is you have one card selected, and now you can either do the broken pass or a different control, right? So this is combining it with another control or doing it twice. So we have the three of diamonds, they replace it, and you say, okay, you won't forget your card, right? And they say no, and you leave it in the middle of the deck, and you've controlled it to the top. Now what you do, either the same thing, or this time I actually prefer a spread. So the second time you do a spread, they select it, and now it kind of makes sense to close it, right? Because there's a spread, you're gonna close the spread. Now, instead of doing a dribble, just swing cut. And now that card is where they're gonna place it back. So they're gonna place the second selection on top of the first selection, because you've done a swing cut. Same idea, and you say, okay, watch, we'll lose those two cards, or you will lose that one card because they don't know they're together in the middle, and you've controlled both on top. So you can either use that swing cut idea with the spread. I'd recommend the spread because then it makes sense, right? If you dribble and they select the card, why would you close it just to swing cut and have them place it back again? I mean, it's probably not a big deal, but I just prefer the spread. So, and that's how you can use this with controlling two cards at separate times, you know, doing either the broken pass twice in a row or using it with another control. Hopefully you guys love that control. I'd absolutely love to know what you think of the broken pass. I think it's a super fun move, and it's really, really great. Just really make sure you just get that down where you have the card replaced, you bring the hands together, and then again, the move, don't even bother really pulling, okay? Don't bother pulling like you would in the past. Just move these fingers to the bottom packet and pull it out. And just pull it out and forward. Use the middle finger and the thumb as a rotation point, and then rotate this up. And that'll give you all the cover you need as you come forward and point and ask them a question. So just do that and you'll be well on your way. And then you get such a clean, beautiful control. So hopefully you guys like the broken pass. I'd love to know what you think in the comments down below. As always, if you'd like any help with anything magic, mentalism related, hit me up for a private lesson. And of course, guys, if you liked the video, don't forget to like. Please subscribe to the channel, it helps me a lot. So don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, and I will catch you in the next video.